Welcome to Silver Bar Stacker, folks, and we're stacking letters today, so let's take a look and see what we got in store. I'm excited to see what is in all of these, so let's figure out the best way to do this. I think scissors might be the best way, so let's go ahead and try that. Well, scissors seems to be the way. Okay. Let's see what else we got going here. There must be, I don't know how many letters in here, but many, many letters. Wow. So I'm not sure. Not sure if there's any silver stackers here who stack sports cards. I've never in my life collected sports cards, I'll tell you that much. However, I do know that a lot of people pay a lot of money for this paper. I also know that there must be a floor. These are tangible assets, paper nonetheless, but that is a tangible asset, right? There is a floor price for physical assets, in my opinion. There's a floor to how much it'll cost to get something shipped to your doorstep, right? So, in my opinion, maybe $1.50 or something is the floor, because the postage itself will cost you that much. So, I'm thinking that there's a good chance that, you know, if you choose the right cards, there's a good chance that you might have it might be desired by somebody. Not saying that you'll turn a profit, because these are pieces of paper at the end of the day. The reason I'm purchasing these is because I feel like I have a use for these. I don't believe that if you don't know what you're doing, there's so many. So the problem is I think that back in the day, from my understanding, there's kind of a few years or whatever, or kind of a sprint of time, a stint of time where they were just mass producing sports cards. And so they really became very devalued during that period of time, I guess you could say. But, I'm not into sports at all, I'll tell you that much. I really strongly don't follow sports at all. But I'll tell you one thing, back in the day, I used to follow the teams from around the areas that I lived in, and so, because of that, there are certain players that are more recognizable to me, from back in the day, right? So, we're talking, we're into kind of vintage collectibles. Well, I'm into kind of vintage everything. I like old school everything, honestly, when it comes to music, when it comes to everything. So, this right here does not seem like it is a sports card. So I'm gonna save this for later, maybe. I don't know. Yeah, this is not a sports card. So I'm gonna check that out here. I think I know what that is, though. And so you're probably wondering, why the heck are you collecting these sports cards? Well, I don't know. I have a friend who said, I don't know how true this is, but, and I don't know what the context of this was, but he was basically saying that, like, well, I've got $1 million worth of sports cards. I'm like, really, do you now? So why don't you go and sell that for $1 million? Well, I don't know if the context was that, oh, if I get these graded, and sell them, I don't know what he's thinking, but $1 million in sports cards, that's a gold mine. Well, I thought, well, I see these cards kind of going for like, I don't know, really, really cheap. Like, some of these were really recognizable people, like Shaq, Michael Jordan. I know these people. They're pretty old, you know. I think everybody knows who these people are. So I just thought, you know, well, why don't I just grab some cards that are a little bit lower risk in the sense that if they're cheaper, right, there's only so much you can lose, right? Maybe that's faulty thinking, but I'm just thinking that way because I don't even mind holding some of these cards because it's like, oh yeah, Michael Jordan. Well, I know Michael Jordan, so it's kind of just like, yeah, this is my card collection, bro. You know, I got some MJs, you know. So I'm just thinking maybe I can just grab a couple, you know, and just grab like duplicates of those, the ones that I'm kind of liking. And then that way, I kind of have a nice collection and I kind of have sequentials, I kind of have duplicates of the cards that I like, and then that way, if, you know, if somebody else likes them, then I don't, it's not a big deal, I can kind of get rid of some of them. So I take that same approach kind of when I was stacking silver, but I guess it kind of works for the sports cards too. And then that way you're staying a little bit focused with your stack, and you're not like, kind of going crazy and being like, oh, I have $1 million worth of sports cards. It's like, I don't want to have $1 million worth of sports cards, and if I did, I would definitely be trying to not have $1 million worth of sports cards. But I do not mind having, you know, $100 worth of sports cards. Certainly don't mind that, because I like sports cards if I know the player. But I don't want to have, like, some, you know, if it's like Larry Bird, cool. But, like, if it's, you know, Steve Coolinger, I don't know who Steve Coolinger is, you know? So I don't want a sports card with Steve Coolinger. I don't want to have the liability of that. I don't think I can get rid of that, even if I paid somebody to take it. So that's all I'm saying. It's like, you got to kind of be careful when, especially when you get into alternative assets that you have no familiarity with. Well, then that way, you know, you can take a risk, but maybe like a smaller risk. And then, you know, if it doesn't work out, then that's fine, right? I just like these because I just find them really cool. And I think that edition number will catch on too. MJ420, baby. So, I just think that it might be a decent idea to kind of stock up on these. And so, I'm always keeping an eye out on these MJs because I just feel like, well, if I have a stack, well, I want to keep adding to that stack, and so I just keep adding to that stack. And then I'm also looking out for other MJs too, and so this is just kind of my thinking. Maybe this doesn't make any sense to people, and maybe it's just going to get me completely wrecked and just me wasting like hundreds of dollars on pieces of paper, but this is another MJ, and I'm just thinking, well, why not? So I'm just thinking, grab MJ cards, right? There's no specialty number there or anything, but I definitely like those 420 MJs. Another person I like a lot is Shaq. I was a big fan of Penny Hardaway, so that's why I had that really cool Penny Hardaway one that you saw way down here. Because this is Penny Hardaway. Usually you know him from Magic, right? Orlando Magic, or, you know, the USA team. But this is some NBA All-Stars turquoise jersey, which is pretty cool. I do quite like that, so I just had to pick that up because it was a very reasonable price. And so I was like, first I was like, oh, let me grab some Penny. But then I was just like, nobody is really super into Penny. So then I was just like thinking, well, let me grab some Shaq for sure. Let me grab some cheap MJs. MJs ones, I guess, are already getting kind of pricey, but these ones were quite cheap. So I feel like, you know, I felt like I got a pretty decent deal there. But, you know, anyways. Over here we got some rounds, actually, so I'm pretty excited to see what kind of rounds these are. It does say here on the packaging that they're prospectors. Looks like I must have won a bid here, and wow, this is a nice bid, actually, because this is a set of a 10th-ounce prospector and a quarter-ounce prospector, and so these quarter-ounce prospectors really are quite, you know, a pain to find, because these are actually only 25 minted. So this is a 25 minted, this quarter ounce, right? And then this right here is a 10,000, so this one is 50,000 minted. Both beautiful rounds, both identical rounds. They both have the silver American Eagle there on the reverse, which is a beautiful reverse. But this is definitely the more common reverse on the prospector rounds. So I do like these a lot, and I'm always looking out for reasonably priced fractionals. And I'm always looking out for more packages that we can take a look at. So I know, you know, it's been kind of a long video, but it's been all sports cards, and I don't want you to think I'm the sports card stacker, you know, but I'm not. I'm a silver bar stacker. So let's take a look and see if we can get some more cool silver to look at. I don't want to, you know, start changing something that, you know, everybody already appreciates and looks forward to. We cannot have any silver in the silver bar stacker video. So these are just some sports cards pickups that I'll probably get wrecked on that I wanted to share with you. These are some generic TD Bank bars. And I think that because I'm showing you this, I think what needs to be done is I think I need to segue into the next video that I had planned, because it's something very important to me. And so I'll just leave it at that. Some nice generic TD Bank 1 ounce silver bars. The beautiful TD Bank stamp logo there on the back. Anyways, I hope you enjoy this next segment. Peace. We've got a extremely heavy and clankety-clanky package for us today, and it's coming from Canada. And so I'm very excited about this, and let's take a look and see what we got in store. I always love a nice Canadian package. They know how to do it right in Canada. That's a nice professional box right there. Oh, wow. Looks like some sort of rounds. Interesting. I don't think I ordered any rounds, but okay. Let's take a look. I'm honestly genuinely confused about what the heck this is, because I really don't think I ordered any rounds. So what could this be? What honestly is this? What kind of rounds are these? I'm sorry, I'm genuinely confused. Because I don't order tubes. I don't order tubes and rounds. I'm a silver bar stacker, and so I don't order tubes of rounds. I'm sorry, I'm not trying to talk bad about them, but other than prospectors, God, I'm such a hypocrite. Other than prospectors, I don't buy tubes of rounds. So let's take a look and see what this is. Interesting. This is a mini tube. This is like a small, narrower tube. Interesting. It's skinnier. Like, look at that. Oh, no, this is the same size. Okay, so I have three tubes, mystery tubes here. I really don't understand what the heck this is. So anyways, let's find out. I really taped this up good, so I'm gonna make sure we are able to get through that tape first. And then that way, that'll make it easy to open this up. Let's see what we got going on here. I'm so confused. Rounds? What is this? From Canada? What rounds did I order from Canada? So confused. And then there's a mini one. Fractional prospector sets? I don't know. I don't understand. Like, what is this? A tube of prospectors? Fractional prospectors? What did I order? I don't know. This is embarrassing. Okay, well, this is the moment of truth, everybody. Interesting. So, this is actually something that I have been waiting to share with you because this is kind of an epic mistake that I made, actually. So what happened here is that I've been collecting vintage, Scotiabank Johnson Matthey and Scotiabank Engelhard bars. And if you go on all Engelhard, you'll notice that there's also some TD Bank vintage Johnson Matthey and Engelhard bars as well. And so the ones that are Engelhard or Johnson Matthey, those are vintage. Now, I kind of made the mistake of trying to ape very, very heavily regular TD Bank stuff, and that is not vintage. And I stupidly did not do my research before purchasing from resellers at marked up prices, and only after placing thousands and thousands of dollars worth of orders on generic, mass-produced TD Bank modern bars and rounds did I realize that TD Bank sells these same products at a much cheaper and much more reasonable price on their Canadian website. And of course, being in the US, I don't think I have access to even purchase those. And I think there's limits, like, if you're not a TD Bank customer, you're limited to like 3 grand worth of products. But the fact remains that I definitely overpaid on a bunch of generic TD stuff from resellers. And so that's fine. They need to make a living, and that's fine. I should have done my research, but I am now over leveraged with generic, perfectly beautiful, these are perfectly beautiful pure silver rounds, but they are not vintage. And as you know, I like to stack vintage. I recently liquidated all of my generic rounds, and these are actually quite cool looking rounds, if I say so myself, which I do because I am myself. But I just think that this is a learning opportunity, right? Like, I purchased these TD Bank rounds, which, by the way, are actually quite beautiful. The more I look at these, I realize that they're actually kind of cool rounds. But this right here is a half ounce round. Okay, so this is a half ounce round, and then this right here is a, oh, I see. This is a chunky McChunkerson. Wow, this is actually a 2 ounce round. So this is a 2 ouncer, a 2 ounce chunker, and then this is your standard 1 ounce round, right? This is a normal 1 ounce round. So I got these sets. I was thinking, oh, this is so cool. I'll get these TD Bank sets of a half ounce, 1 ounce, and 3 ounce round. I bought, I think, like 9 or 10 of these sets. So now I've got these sets, which are very cool, but they're not vintage. They're just generic things that you can buy right now. If you're Canadian, you can go right now on TD Bank website, and they're actually quite reasonably priced. So if you like what these look like, go buy them, right? Like, don't buy them from SVS, that's for sure, because SVS overpaid for them, and so he's gonna have to pay a lot of money, or he's gonna have to sell them for money, or he's gonna have to sell them at a loss. Maybe, I don't know, maybe they'll eventually run out of these, but these look like mass-produced rounds, right? And so it is what it is. Made a mistake, but I think because of this, what's gonna have to happen is I'm gonna have to figure out, well, I'm wanting to stack vintage. I'm trying to get rid of my generic stuff, and I already, in fact, have gotten rid of my generic stuff. And so, I think, looking at the schedule that we were talking about previously, Wednesday, I'm sorry, Tuesday was supposed to be to be determined Tuesday. And so now I'm just thinking, like, well, maybe instead of to be determined Tuesday, we could just call it like TD Tuesdays, because we've got all this TD Bank, these TD Bank rounds, and heck, I don't know, I'm not sure if that's what's in here, but who knows, what's in this package. I mean, this could be more TD Bank stuff, because I mean, it's not just rounds that I bought a lot of stuff. And so, it's very possible that, these right here could potentially be more TD Bank generic stuff. I'm not sure. Let's find out. This came from a different seller, but I just recently bought all that stuff at the same time, and so I don't know. It's very possible that, yep, it sure is. This is all TD, more TD Bank. This is just normal TD Bank stuff. You can get this stuff on the TD Bank website in Canada. I don't think you can buy bullion like that here in the States on a bank's website. I certainly can't go to, Chase or Bank of America or Wells Fargo and just go buy bullion on their website for a really reasonable price and a really, cool. Like, these are nice bars. Like, if I was stacking generic bullion, I might go on a TD Bank's website and stack these bars and rounds because they look really nice, honestly. And yeah, I guess I just don't know what to say. They're quite nice. quite solid bars. Oh, here's some more. Right, so, geez, this is so many. I don't know what I'm gonna do. So I think because of this, I knew I overleveraged in these. And none of these are vintage. These are great bars, beautiful bars, they're straight bullion. But at the end of the day, these are not vintage. And I bought these and overpaid for these with the expectation and understanding that these were probably vintage. I wasn't positive, but I was thinking like that might be the case. I don't know what these rounds are, but maybe another duplicate of these rounds, I'm not sure. But anyways, so I'm thinking now we could have TD Tuesdays, where we would basically pick out a random, grab, like we'll have a mystery item, which will be either vintage TD Bank stuff or generic TD Bank stuff, and we will take, one of these generic TD Bank bars or rounds, and we'll just do a vote on YouTube. On YouTube, every Tuesday, we're gonna open up a mystery package with a random TD Bank item. It might be a vintage TD Bank item. It might be a generic TD Bank item. Whatever that item is, we will unbox it, and then we will do a vote on the YouTube channel, and I will have you guys vote. Do we either want to include this in a weekly stack pack, which we release on Sundays, or do we want to have this be included in a channel subscription stack pack? And so I want to do some channel subscription stack packs, which will be structured a little bit differently than the auction stack packs. So the auction stack packs happen every Sunday, and we will drop anywhere between 5 to 10 stack packs every Sunday. And those are going to all start at $1, and people will be free to bid on those. And they all start at $1, and whoever bids the highest gets that particular stack pack. I'm also going to do stack packs in the form of a subscription, a monthly subscription, and I'm going to have three different tiers for that, where essentially there's going to be three tiers. The first tier is just going to be like a $10 a month tier for people who are kind of on a really tight budget, and really, you know, it might not even be that you're on a tight budget, but it might be that you might want to just support my channel and also kind of get a little memento from me every month. Or it might just be that you're trying to stack from multiple sources, and so you might want to just stack $10 from this subscription, and then maybe, you know, $10 from another 9 subscriptions for $100 a month or whatever it is. So everybody has their own stacking strategy, and so what I'm trying to do with these stack packs is make vintage and fractional bullion a little bit more accessible to everybody, especially the vintage stuff. It's kind of hard to find at a reasonable price, and so if you're in a position like, you know, people like me or like Savage Stacker, we like to just find those deals, and we have the resources to be able to buy in bulk and maybe get a deal and strike deals. And so I want to be able to give back, right? I want to be able to make this accessible for everybody. I don't want to just hoard it for myself. And so that's kind of the vision behind the stack packs, is making it a little bit more accessible. And so for the channel stack packs, what I'd like to do is have a few different tiers, where that first, you know, lowest tier might be like $10 a month, something very accessible, very affordable for all. We might have a significant amount of those available. And then we might have a second tier that might be like, you know, $40 or $50 a month, and then you might have a third tier that might be like $100 a month. And so each channel pack will be, there'll be many randomized packs that are made every month, and you'll be, you know, randomly chosen and assigned to one of those packs, which you'll receive. And each tier will have one VIP pack, which is going to have stuff in it that's like serious bonus items. Like there's going to be seriously premium vintage products, rare products, like included in those VIP packs, and those are going to be every 10th day, on the 10th, the 20th, and the 30th of the month, on the 1st, the 10th, and the 20th of the month, we're going to, each of those days, we're going to choose one from each of the tiers, one of the VIP packages, who's going to actually win it, which of the subscribers, which of the monthly stack pack subscribers are actually going to win that VIP package. And so everybody's going to get something that's pretty much worth the money, but certain select people, one from each tier, is going to get some extremely extra bonus item, right? So what I was thinking was like that first tier of $10, you know, obviously you're not going to be getting an ounce of silver if you're just tossing $10 in, but I'm thinking, and then shipping costs money as well. So what I was thinking was like, you know, you could just get like a stack pack with like, you know, a variety pack of like, you know, 4 grams or, you know, something like that. I'll be losing money on that. But my thinking is that, you know, the initial people who kind of support this channel subscription pack, stack pack, they're really getting their stuff at kind of cost or below cost. And as those first round of channel subscription snack packs fill up, then we'll release another tier for a slightly higher cost to then start kind of offsetting the cost on my end. So, but anyways, so like, you know, for me, I generally pay, when I buy grams, I pay like a dollar, like the cheapest gram I usually find if I buy them in bulk is like 170-ish per gram. I used to be able to get them for like 150-ish, but anyways, right? Like, so after shipping and blah, 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 you know, like $2 to $2.50 a gram is pretty reasonable, right? Not shipped, but like that's kind of like a base cost if you're buying like literally grams of silver. So what I was thinking is maybe like tossing in 4 grams of silver plus like a bonus item for any of those $10 a month subscribers, right? And then you might have one VIP pack that has maybe like one premium product. Like it might be, oh, there is an ounce of silver in one of those packs, or you know, it might be like a vintage Jensen Matthew gram, or like one of those unsealed Geigergrams, or some Geigergrams, right? So something cool like that for those lower tier subscriptions to make it fun and to sort of gamify it. Everybody's going to get something quality, right? But every month, one lucky person is going to get something even more quality. And so then for the second tier, what I was thinking was like, okay, well, if it's 40 or 50 bucks, well, for that, I can definitely give an ounce of silver, because an ounce of silver spot, you know, I mean, I don't buy anything at spot. I buy everything above, well above spot. But regardless, you know, for 50 bucks, you know, an ounce of silver plus maybe like, you know, whatever, a few grams, like a couple grams or something, plus another bonus item, like it could be a mystery item, like it could be like a sticker pack or like some free music or, you know, another channel's sticker pack or, you know, things like that. Just, it'll be a random surprise gift. And each tier will get that will get a random surprise gift. And each pack will be unique, right? And each person will get a different pack. And then on tier three, you know, you might have like an ounce of silver, maybe a gram of silver, and then maybe like one, you know, vintage ounce of silver. So it might be like 2 ounces of silver plus a gram. And one of those ounces might be like, is always going to be a vintage, right? So that's kind of what I was thinking for the three tiers. Keep it simple, keep it accessible, keep it exciting. And keep it really a good deal, right? This is not about me trying to like make money, but me trying to make vintage silver a little bit more accessible, right? We got lots of perspective rounds to pass around, and so that'll definitely be like a common thing that you'll see in these, at least the channel subscription stack packs. I've been putting the eBay stack packs, I've been putting some perspective rounds in some of them as well, and those are the ones that generally sell for the most. But anyways, I just thought that because I made this mistake of over leveraging myself on all of this generic TD Bank stuff, well, I think it would be kind of cool to sort of give back in the sense that, like, well, every single week, every single Tuesday, we might go into the TD grab bag. Some of there's going to be, like, vintage grams of TD gold, Johnson Matthey gold, Scotiabank gold. You know, there'll be, like, some interesting things in there in that grab bag. And sometimes it'll be generic. Sometimes it'll be vintage. Whatever it is, we'll take something out, and then we will decide collectively as a team, what do we want to do, guys and gals? Do we want to auction this off on an eBay stack pack this upcoming Sunday, or do we want to include this in one of the channel subscription stack packs? And so once I have the actual channel subscription stack packs going, then we can roll out TD Tuesday and have some fun. So, and you know, I'll provide all the details and stuff, and maybe we have some more TD Bank stuff coming in too, who knows. So anyways, I just wanted to let you know that this is kind of my plan for what TBT turned into Tuesday was. I'd like to call it TD Tuesday. And eventually my goal here, guys and gals, just so you know, I spoke to my business partner about this and we had a good laugh. I don't know if you know this about me, but I constantly talk about how I absolutely hate banks, and I try to take advantage of banks anytime I get the chance, and I try to just screw with them, because I hate banks, and I have no respect for banks, and that includes TD Bank. And so I was almost thinking we could call, you know, we could be like, we could open up, we could have each package say the words FUCK banks on it, or something very in your face like that. And the reason is because I don't have respect for banks. However, I will stop talking crap about banks if TD Bank or any other bank sponsors TD Tuesdays, right? And if we need to change the name of TD Tuesdays to, you know, Bank of America Tuesdays, I will do that. But what it's going to take is that I'm going to need TD Bank or any bank, Scotiabank, any bank that wants to, I want them to sponsor TD Tuesdays, and I would like you to provide us with 10 ounces of silver every Tuesday so that we can auction those off to our channel subscribers. And you know, if you would like that sponsorship opportunity, that's what it's going to take. It's going to take that 10 ounces of silver per week so that we can auction that off. It'll be free promotion for your bank, and we will also be able to provide some of that free branded silver to our subscriber base. We're open to offers. Right now, TD Bank, no bank has taken up the sponsorship opportunity, and so we're open to offers. 10 ounces is really what we're shooting for every month, but sorry, every week. But if you would like to make an offer, we may or may not accept the sponsorship opportunity. But please contact us if you are a bank and you would like to sponsor our Tuesday giveaways. Until then, all of our packages, all of our unboxing packages for TD Tuesday, will say the words FUCK Banks on them. And as soon as we get a bank to sponsor, we can brand the packages with either that bank's logo or just simply remove the FUCK Banks language. And what we will then do is start auctioning off bars and rounds sponsored by that bank. Until we get that sponsorship in place, I will be committing to sponsoring the giveaways, and so or the auctions, right? It is the product for the auctions, and so I will be comfortable giving away a TD Bank product every single week, auctioning that off, and maybe including it in a stack pack or a channel pack. That's up to the community to decide via upvotes on the comments section of the YouTube video. But that's what TD Tuesdays is all about. We're striving to get sponsorship from a bank to provide us with free bars to auction off to the community, so creating generational wealth for everybody. Peace out, everybody. Hey, 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 hey